This tree doesn't have a single animation keyframe drawn by hand. The leaves moving on the wind are fully driven by the new node system. If you ever used Blender or Unity, you might be familiar with how it works. A node is an individual building block that takes some inputs, does some processing, and returns one or multiple outputs. By connecting nodes together, you can create complex effects, animations, shapes, colors, and much more. Here are a few more examples. This combination of nodes automatically creates an outline for your drawing. Here we have a layer displayed as a node. It has many inputs and one output, which is an image. We then take this image and separate four color channels from it using separate channels node. This node takes an input image and creates four images composed only of values from one color channel: red, green, blue, and alpha, which is a transparency. This is important because we only care whether the pixel is transparent or not. Color values are irrelevant. And now the most important step. Time for some magic. We apply something called kernel filter. I will not go into details of how kernel filters work, but I want to make a separate video about it though. It's fascinating what you can do with them. Here are some other examples of kernel filters usage. Okay, let's come back to our outline effect. When we connect what we have so far to the output, we can see that outline is visible, but the color is missing. It's not something we want, but still a cool effect though. The last step we have to do is to combine our layer with generated one. Let's use merge node for that. And that's it, we have an outline. Don't worry though, to make this kind of effect you won't need to use kernel filter or any other scary named thing. There will be a single node that will create common effects like that, with just a single input. Nodes are one of the most fun things I made. There are other fascinating procedural generation related topics I want to cover in the future, but this is it for this short devlog. If you are interested about this kind of stuff, make sure to join PixiEditor's newsletter, and you'll be the first to know about beta tests and new stuff. Have a lovely day! Cheers!